Hi, my name is Andrew Suryadi, CEO and co-founder of Dapur Animasi, an online platform education of 3D animation, design, and creative in Indonesia. First of all, I want to say thank you so much for the honor of having me as one of the speakers for this Chaos Group event. A big thank you for Mr. Renaldo Handaya from 2G Academy, who already invites me to this event as one of the speakers. In this presentation, I want to share with you how I start my journey from a 3D artist to become a business owner in education field with all its ups and downs. Chapter 1. The Beginning and Professional Career. In 2004, I started my journey to learn about 3D animation. I took some courses, a short and an intensive course on how to create 3D animation. It was a very exciting experience to learn on how to create something out of nothing digitally. Since that moment, I determined to dig deeper on how to make a career in 3D animation industry. Start from 2006, I started to work professionally in an animation company in Jakarta as a 3D generalist and animator. In 2008, I went to work in Singapore as a 3D exhibition designer until 2011. In 2012, I started to work as a freelance, mainly as a freelance matte painting artist. I did matte painting backgrounds for a short animation and several local TV commercials in Indonesia. After that, I started my teaching career as a lecturer in 3D animation major at SAE Institute from 2015 until 2018, and as a creative media lecturer at CCIT Universitas Indonesia from 2019 until now. Chapter 2, Build Education Business. Start from 2016, me and my friends Rangga Yudo Yuwono and Benasi Tompul, we became business partner to build an online learning platform for 3D animation and creative design in Indonesia that called Dapur Animasi. In Indonesia, dapur means kitchen. It means the company is a place where we can mix animation recipe and produce something good out of it for many people as well as for the animation and creative industry. Yes, that's the main idea for Dapur Animasi. In 2017, we made our first public appearance in MNC World News since our first launching. These are some of the Dapur Animasi students' portfolio. We have classes for 3D modeling, environment matte painting, digital compositing, and basic 3D animation. Dapur Animasi has already produced students who now work in a big company or studio. Some of them are still continuing their study in Indonesia or overseas. To give more impact to many people in Indonesia, we collaborate with a learning platform called Nobelajar Apa to contribute in government project called Prakerja in 2020 until 2021. Prakerja is a government initiative to help educate people, build their professional career, and encourage entrepreneurship with many new skills. In Prakerja, we have a chance to contribute with graphic design skill education to help many people improve in their professional career and in their entrepreneurship journey. And for 2022, we continue to expand our collaboration further to provide workshop and extracurricular for school and also develop video-based learning education products with our partner. We do this to expand our further support for many people who wants to learn about animation, design, and creative skill. Chapter 3, The Struggle from Artist to Become a Business Owner. As an artist, I don't really have a background and know how to run a company. So the struggle from how I start my journey as an artist to become a business owner is very real. In the next couple of slides, I'm going to share with you what are the struggles that I experienced along the way when I run this company as a business owner. The biggest challenge in transition from an artist to business owner is the mindset. From all by myself mindset to delegation to team mindset. From only developing personal portfolio to developing people and team. Followed by many things to learn, like leadership, management, cash flow and financial, legal and tax, product development, sales and marketing, etc., etc. These are the struggles that we have along the way, such as people come and go, and sometimes we didn't have a clear vision. There was a time we didn't have a permanent building as an office, and we struggled to find a solid marketing plan and strategy. From my experiences, it is good for an artist that wants to become a business owner to equip themselves with leadership capability, a good communication and networking skill, team building skill, basic finance and accounting, and also basic in branding, sales and marketing.
These are the factors that are very important in building a business. So now it's not only about build a portfolio, even though it is very important, but on how to grow together as a company and a team. So that's about it. A brief presentation on how I started my journey from an artist to become a business owner in an education field. Of course, the ups and downs are still there, and with those ups and downs, we are still learning and we're still growing. So hopefully you can find this useful. Thank you so much for watching. See you around and bye-bye.